Today you will see a bridge between two Ethereum-like chains with a mechanism for general state synchronization. Presently, bridges have been built due to a need for scaling Ethereum and avoiding big gas fees. Most bridges have required a trusted authority and separate development effort for each use case, for example, each ERC standard for tokens. Our bridge can handle general states, and you will see an example of syncing state mutated on one chain to a second chain. We are in the Factotum IDE, and I have set up an environment with two EVM-based test chains. We will be using the same account address on each chain, and this is important because we are effectively replaying the transaction sent from chain A on chain B. We have deployed two counter contracts, one on each chain, and they have the same address. Then we have a light client contract on chain B, which keeps track of chain A blocks and stores block hashes, and a prover contract on chain B, to which we will send the transaction data that needs to be replayed on chain B. Now let's look at the counter contract states. On chain A, the counter is 14. And on chain B, also 14, so the states are in sync. Now we will make a transaction on chain A, which increases the counter value with 2. And we have our receipt here. So now, when we query the chains, we can see value 16 on chain A and still 14 on chain B, so the values are not in sync. During this time, the light client watcher has picked up the new block from chain A in which the increment counter transaction has been added and has sent it to the light client. So we can proceed and build our proofs for the prover contract. The forward and verify function takes in a transaction, receipt, and sender account proofs for the transaction that we want replayed, along with the block header where the transaction has been included. Let's get the block header for the block number in our receipt. The header contains the transaction root, receipt root, and state root, the receipt tree root, along with the receipt proof calculated here, allows the prover contract to verify that the status of the original transaction is the same as the status for the replayed transaction. The transaction root along with this transaction proof enables the prover to verify that the replayed transaction included already in the proof is part of the transaction tree sealed by the block. The prover contract also checks that the RLP serialized block header is hashed to a valid block hash that has been registered with the light client. Last, we send the account proof. To make sure we know a valid account nonce, which is used as a monotonically increasing value for tracking the state changes in order, thus disallowing the reuse of the same transaction for replay. The prover contract keeps a mapping of nonces per transaction sender account and, at least in the current version, does not allow nonces to be skipped. Now we can send the forward and verify transaction, and we can check the counter values again. 16 on chain A as we had before, and now on chain B we have 16 and the state is now synced. You have seen a short demo of bridging two Ethereum chains and keeping state in sync by proving blocks, transactions, receipts, and account information, all inside Factotum IDE.